Hello guys, and welcome to the second flight of this Bahrain leg of the Formula One World Tour with Max Verstappen. And today, or this morning, we're going to be going from Ankara to Al Basra, and potentially onto Bahrain as well. It's not too far after Al Basra, so we may do the whole flight. But we've just refueled here at Ankara. And we'll need one more fuel stop in Iraq, so that's why we're stopping at Al Basra. And yeah, we've got 7,000 kilograms of fuel on board now, so we've got a full tank. Should be able to make it a bit better this time. I do know what happened in the last flight. This aircraft is a bit dodgy, and when I loaded the or turned on the engines, used the sort of automatic turn on after the engines wouldn't start. That put the fuel down to about 3,000 pounds, so it's about 1,000 in each tank or 1,500 in each tank. So that is what happened, and I'm going to check that before we take off this time. So we should be okay, and we're definitely a bit lighter this flight. Last flight I tried to fly with 10,000 kilograms, whereas now we're flying with about 3,000. So should be much better. Well, no, 7,000 I think it is. Because basically in the FS Charter app, I'm using a Falcon 7X, which holds about 14,000 kilograms, whereas this one only holds 7,000. So that's where the discrepancy was. So yeah. I'm just going to finish off putting the files and stuff. I need them. Well, the flight plan on VATSIM, we're live on VATSIM right now. I don't think there's any control on. There's no control on at the moment. But okay, we'll still do all the call-outs because we have traffic around us at LTAC. So yeah, let's hop into the cockpit. I believe Max Verstappen is on board now, so we can okay, this thing fired up. Not sure why that's cool. Let's load up the checklist.
Set autopilot to NAV as required by ATC, flight plan. Power levers to full, rotate and take off. APU stop, off. Left and right hand bus, untied vertical. Anti-collision lights, all. Active database, current. IRS, align. Battery 1 and 2, on. Conditioning temp controls, auto 10 o'clock. Anti-skid, number 1 on. Chocks and covers in place, static elements on. Review, then continue to pre-flight checklist. Chocks and covers in place, static elements on. Review, then continue to pre-flight checklist. Review, then continue to performance data. Welcome aboard. When ready, continue to reference data. Review, then continue to performance data. Review, then continue to pre-flight checklist. Chocks and covers in place.
There we go.
Static elements on.
We didn't know that's okay.
Start exterior inspection.
We don't need to do that.
Complete. Remove chocks and covers, static elements off. Checked. Cabin door and main hatch.
Close.
Closed. Parking brakes. Engaged.
Yeah.
Failure warning lights, reset test switch. Checked. Floor switch, off. Checked. Audio VHF 1 and 2, pressed. Set. Microphone VHF 1 and 2, pressed. set. Volume knobs, high, full clockwise. Set. Static selector, normal. Set. Fire pull handles, 1, 2 and 3 pushed in.
Why is that not working?
Check.
It's in anyway.
Fire extinguisher switches 1 to 6, off. Checked. Landing gear handle, down.
Down.
Checked. Emergency gear pull handle, in.
In.
Checked. Co-pilot Pato static selector, normal. Checked. Anti-skid, number 1 on. Checked. Hydraulic standby pump, on. Set. Thrust reverser, normal and locked. Checked. Cabin pressure selector, auto and locked. Checked. Cabin manual pressurization, down and hold, set to current altitude. Set. Visual check cabin triple indicator, left hand pilot panel. Checked. Air brake, set to zero. Checked. Power levers, cut off. Checked. Slat flap handle, clean. Checked. Co-pilot floor switch, off. Set. Conditioning temp controls, auto 10 o'clock. Set. Left hand and right hand bus, tied, horizontal. Checked. Battery 1 and 2, off. Checked. Generator 1, 2 and 3, on. Checked. Computer 1, 2 and 3, set to auto. Set. Motor 1, 2 and 3, set to ground start. Set. Transfer pumps 1, 2 and 3, off. Checked. Transfer intercom 1 and 2, untied, vertical. Checked. Booster pumps 1, 2 and 3, off. Checked. Crossfeed 1 and 2, untied, vertical. Checked. Pato pilot and co-pilot, off. Checked. Windshield pilot and co-pilot and side, off. Checked. Bleed air HP 123 and APU, auto. Set. Bleed air isolation, tied, horizontal. Set. Bleed air, cabin and crew, auto. Set. Bleed air bag, on. Set. Anti-ice engine 123 and wings, off. Set. Battery 1 and 2, on.
No takeoff. Set.
Booster pump 2, on. Set. APU master, on.
Set. So I'm not going to use the APU this time, I'm going to use ground power.
Set. External power, on. Set. Brake selector, intermediate indent.
I think you still have to turn those on, the APU, master and start stop, but I'm not too sure.
Set. External lights, to NAV. Set. Fasten seat belts and no smoking, on. Set. Emergency lights, arm. Set. Pilot and co-pilot AV master, overhead, on. Set. Audio VHF 1, pressed. Set. Master warning and master caution. Reset. Fuel, refuel as necessary, 40% minimum. Checked. Fuel used counter, reset. Set. Hydraulic standby pump, auto. Set. SLAT system stall 2 test, press. Set. IRS, align. Set. Barometric value, local QNH.
Okay, so let's get the QNH. 3006.
Set. File flight plan with ATC.
We've already done that.
Complete. Initial transponder code to 2000. Set. Active database, current.
Okay, so now it's time to do the flight plan. So we're going from LTAC ORMM, which is Basra. That. I always forget to update the nav data, but we're not going to do it now. So. Okay, anyway. So that's that. Departure. Have a look at the departure. Unload that. Import sim brief. There's 21 left. Kubi 1B. Hold on. 21 left. B. Mode transition, and then the arrival. Going to be runway 14. Runway 14 from and direct from Ilmac. PM 14 and vectors. That'll do. Climb. We need to have a look at some charts here. Transition alt is 10,000. Cruise for this flight. Let's have a look at that. Cruising that today. 27,000. Cruise out. We're just going to leave that as it is. Everything else in there is fine. So if we go to legs, let's check our flight plan. Preferences. Okay. That. Lovely. That's all done.
Anti-collision lights, all. Set.
Let's get the engine started.
Booster pump 2, on. Set. Press to start 2, on.
Booster 2 on, press to start 2.
Set. Power lever number 2, to idle when N2
power
stable.
Coming up there. And I usually wait until it gets about 12 to...
Set. Visual check N2, ITT, N1, hydraulic pressure. Check. External power, off remove. Set. SLAT system stall 1 test, press. Set. Booster pump 3, on.
Pump 3.
Set. Press to start 3, on. Set. Power lever number 3, to idle when N2
and N2's
stable.
N2's going up there. Are these switches
set? Visual check N2, ITT, N1, hydraulic pressure. Check. Booster pump 1, on.
Booster pump 1.
Set.
The last engine.
Press to start 1, on.
Start.
Set. Power lever number 1, to idle when N2 stable.
Okay. Start.
Set. Visual check N2, ITT, N1, hydraulic That's pressure. Fine. Left and right hand bus, untied vertical. Set.
Cool.
All failure warning lights off, except PITO.
Yeah. That's our pumps on. Yep, that's fine.
Checked. Transfer pumps 1, 2, 3, on. Check. Hydraulic standby pump, auto. Check. Cabin pressure controller, rate to 2,000 feet per minute. Set. Cabin pressure controller, barometer QNH. Set. Cabin pressure controller, cabin altitude to cruise altitude. Set. Visual check cabin triple indicator, left hand pilot panel.
Visual check, trip indicator, that should be fine.
Checked. Yaw dampener, off.
Off.
Set.
Pitch
trim stabilizer, 5 degrees set. Checked. IRS aligned, then set to NAV. Set. Set assigned transponder code.
We haven't got a transponder code because there's no ATC online.
Set. Heading bug, aligned to departure runway.
Departure runway is 1. Right there.
Set. Flight guidance heading, on. Set. Flight guidance initial altitude.
I'm just gonna have a look at these charts. So we have no restrictions, so we're just going to set the out 290, which is our cruise altitude. Lovely.
FLC set. Flight guidance initial speed.
Climate 150, which is fine.
Set. Autopilot, disconnect. Set. Parking brakes, disengage. Set. ATC request pushback, if required.
Not required. Taxi lights on. anti-collision lights and the landing lights.
APU stop, off. Set. APU master, off.
Transfer intercom set. Vertical.
Transfer intercom
vertical.
1 and 2, untied, vertical. Set.
Pizza.
Crossfeed 1 and 2, untied, vertical. Set. Autopilot and co-pilot, on. Set. Motor okay. Start 1, 2, 3, air, start. Set. Go to holding point and set park brakes.
So we're ready to taxi, basically. Oh, 21 left. There. So if we get up a chart, a taxi chart. Okay, and now we just need to do a call. So, Ankara traffic, taxiing to holding point Alpha 2 for runway, runway 21 left via Hotel Sierra 2 and Alpha. Papa Hotel, Delta Tango, Foxtrot, Ankara traffic. Oh, our mic isn't connected. this is a pain in the ass. But the microphone and. There we go. That was just a little practice run. Ankara traffic, taxiing to holding point Alpha 2, runway 21 left via Hotel Sierra 2 and Alpha. That's Papa Hotel, Delta Tango, Foxtrot, and Ankara traffic. Okay. Ready for taxi. So we're just going to spin around, take the first right, straight until no more, and then spit all the way. Okay. Let's get the show on the road. Alpha Bravo. I probably should have said that instead of Hotel Sierra 2, but okay. And I like to get some of this stuff done during taxi, so we can go flaps 2, headings aligned, autopilot's okay. FMS 1 is fine. Takeoff references is fine. and everything is fine. So we can
power levers to full, rotate and take off.
A little picture there. Come on, Falcon. Up the hill. And we're just going to go all the way to the end. And I have checked the fuel we have. Strangely enough, I don't understand the way the fuel works on this. Actually, this is pounds, so that's probably why. But yeah, we should have enough fuel on board. And one thing I didn't check is the FS Charter plugin. It says we're fine to taxi and take off, so good on there. A little fast here, so let's use the power. Slow as we get to the corner, just so we don't get out of control. And here we are, Alpha 2. And car traffic lining up runway 21 left, Papa Hotel Delta Tango Foxtrot, and car traffic. We can enter the runway. We have no one landing, which is good. Okay, so we're all set. Let's get the SID chart up. So we got a Kubi 1B. Kubi 1B, what's that? Kuba 1B. And car traffic departing runway 21 left, a Kubi 1 Bravo departure, and we're going to climb straight to 290, flight level 290. And car traffic, Papa Hotel Delta Tango Foxtrot. Okay, release the parking brake. Yep. Okay. And power. Let's get out of here. I wonder what the performance is going to be like with this fuel on board. I'm hoping that we'll be able to get a lift off at the right speed. We'll go for 115 because we're loaded. Gear up. Flaps. And I'm going to switch over to nav straight away. Autopilot on. Not over sure why that's beeping at me. There's minimums, that's what that means, but minimums of what? Okay, so AP's on, motor start is at ground. Landing lights come, but they stay until 10,000. Taxi lights come off. Once we're at 10,000, we'll land in. That's all. Past 10,000 now, so we can turn the landing lights off. And the barometer needs to go to 2992. There we go. And we're just going to keep climbing.
Go set to the next autopilot page. Autopilot to NAV as required by ATC.
Above 10,000.
Fasten seat belts.
Come off.
Off. Set. Altimeter. Set 1013 or 29.92.
That's fine. We are
continue
going to,
put to the descend.
Anti-ice on.
Altimeter. Set QNH. Continue to descend.
Ooh. We're good for that now. 21,000. Everything's fine, route plan's followed. Just check to see how long we got until we get to top of descent. So we've got about a 2 hour cruise, it looks like. Maybe a little less. Did forget to do a call. I'll do it now. Ankara traffic clear of runway 21 left. That's Papa Hotel Delta Tango Foxtrot Ankara traffic. Sadly, I don't think we're going to have any control over the course of this flight unless Turkey come online in the next, 30 minutes or so. I highly doubt we're going to get any through Iraq, Iran, anywhere down there. Syria, most likely not. So, yeah. Be a pretty peaceful cruise. I'm gonna try and keep an eye on the fuel on this flight. You don't want to run out. About 2.5 hours, so we're gonna burn about 2,500 fuel in each tank right now, which we have more than enough. Okay, so we're almost up at 290, entering the cruise stage of the flight. And I'm going to quickly check on the Navigraph. Ankara traffic passing Cuba at 290, flight level 290. And Papa Hotel Delta Tango Foxtrot, Ankara traffic. Now we're in the cruise stage, so we should start to speed up. About Mach 80. Is good from what I can tell. I'm just gonna have a little play with this volume control. Wondering if this affects the outside of the aircraft. I don't think that actually works. Oh, it does. Ah, okay. It does work. Did I just press? I don't know what I just pressed, but I'm sure we'll find out soon. So we're up at cruise speed now, we're about Mach 8.1. And according to our fuel, we should have enough fuel to cruise at Mach 8.1 the whole way. So I'm going to leave that at max and hopefully we don't get the flight invalidated. We're going too fast. Yeah, so far everything's going well. Just flying over the remainder of Turkey and yeah, we're on our way to Al Basra, Iraq. Quite interested to see what this Al Basra will look like. I've only seen it on the news before. I've never flown there in sim. In fact, I've never really flown anywhere around this part of the world before. I think the most or furthest east I've gone is... Have a look, where are we now? I mean, I fly to Greece, which is not far from Turkey. Where is Dubai? I mean, I don't think anyone's flying there right now, but I fly to Dubai. Little bit. Oh, yeah. That's about as far east as I go. I do have a commercial operation on FS Charter with a A321 XLR, which I do fly, you know, some other places a bit further east. I mean, my A321 is at VRMM, which is Male at the moment. Very nice airport to land at. And definitely it looks like a nice place to go, but that's just off the Indian coast sort of area, like Thailand I believe, or Malaysia is it? Yeah, just off the Thailand sort of coast, high coast. Yeah, I don't really fly this sort of area, so it'd be interesting to see sort of what the Middle East has to offer in terms of runways. And it'd be interesting to see what the scenery looks like as well, because I imagine it's a lot of sort of savanna, desert sort of terrain, a lot of mountains. And again, the scenery inside X-Plane, whether they sort of cater for the OSM data and all the buildings and stuff. So, interesting. Right now it looks like there's a event going on in India at New Delhi Airport. They have complete coverage, and I'm hoping, it seems to me that there's a lot of planes going to Bahrain. King Khalid International, King Khalid International. Bahrain. There's like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. There's like 11 planes all coming out of New Delhi right now. So I'm hoping by the time we get down to Bahrain or whatever it is, Bahrain. We should have ATC down there. The Saudi, or United Arab Emirates, radar is online, so hopefully that it will extend up once he sees all these planes coming. Basra is not far from the coastline of Iraq and Kuwait. So we should have a nice short hop across the water there to Bahrain. And currently we are almost directly over the center of Turkey. So and we're off the departure now. So we should have a solid cruise all the way down to Bahrain now. I don't know if this wants us at another flight level. Then 270, I think I might have climbed a bit too high, but we can change up. We're okay at 29 flying this direction. We got an hour and 50 minutes to top of descent. I'm going to check what time all these planes are getting to Bahrain, because maybe we can... they're going to be there way before me. But we can check the schedule. I think we may have to check it on the next flight, because because we're not on the list there. Mate, someone's going from Rio de Janeiro to Bahrain. That's insane. That's a very long flight, my gosh. Oh, I've just closed it by accident. Bear on me. But yeah, we can see our predicted arrival into Basra. Have a look at that. It'll be 12:23 Zulu. Get there? 12:23 Zulu. Like I say, once we're a bit closer or landed at Basra, we can check our arrival time there. Fuel is okay, we're burning within a good parameters. Everything's going fine. I may just leave this outside the cockpit for now. We leave it like that, just so you can enjoy the scenery. And yeah, I guess I'm gonna pop back in a little bit and see where we're at. We've got quite a long cruise. I'm gonna probably go and make some breakfast quickly, have like a bacon and egg sandwich. And yeah, I'll be back shortly. So enjoy the scenery and see you soon. Hi guys, so as you can see, we are exiting the Turkish airspace and we're heading over into Syria right now. You can see by the terrain change there, colours are a bit different, but yeah, I'm not sure how it changes from, you know, wet green grass and the it is so abruptly, but I don't know the scene. But yeah, we're just flying into Syria now. We're gonna have a short flight over Syria into Iraq, and then we're just gonna cruise on down to Basra. Right now we're probably under halfway, so we've still got a little bit left to go, and yeah, almost we're over halfway to Ukraine. So once we get to Iraq, we probably have a try and work this out. Probably an hour, 45 minutes, an hour hop from Iraq to Bahrain. That will finish up the first leg of this world tour. And obviously, we've gone from Cannes in France, which is where Verstappen's plane started, and we've gone over to Turkey for refuel. Then we're going to go down to Iraq for a refuel, and then the last leg. Done. So, quite sure how far in total we've flown, but in a considerable distance, considering we had to refuel three times. Nice. But that's definitely not the longest flight, that's for sure. Pretty small actually compared to some of the other ones I've checked in the last video. We went through the calendar and worked out how far all the legs are, and there's some pretty big ones. Good one to start off with. We're going to some new places. The Turkey I've not flown into before. I've been there in real life, but I've never flown there. And Iraq, I've never been there, but I've never flown there either. It's been a good flight so far. Things have gone as planned. This one particularly, last flight, obviously it was a bit of an issue, but we still made it. But this one should be a lot more relaxed, and we can descend with the correct profile and the powers even it. So the landing and the approach for this one should be a lot better. It looks like we're going to have a straight in approach from Ilmap, the runway 14, and DOR the only approach, so I don't have any sort of guidance. Not that I think the guidance is working on this plane, but yeah. Let me just quickly check the chart VORDM. Alright, Hockham, we need to be at 3000. Just a visual approach, there's no guidance at all. This is the transition altitude. And so, so again, just gonna kick back, relax, and
clouds shallow.
Look like water on the ground. Again, I don't make scenery, so. Yeah, hopefully we can get a good picture on the way down, and what I'm gonna do for the next half of the flight. Really quickly. But for the second half of this flight, I'm just gonna do a bit of design. I've got to do some thumbnails for the last video. Yeah, hopefully. By the time I've done that, we should almost be ready for. Our descent will be quite late. In the flight this time, we're only at 290 rather than 410. So, move it pretty late. Yeah, enjoy the clouds and the scenery over Rio and the Rack here. Yeah, I'll get back in once we get there. So, thank you, and the rest of the flight. Okay, so I'm just going to check up on the flight. I believe we should be near to the top of the descent now. Yep, so we're 3 minutes away. And what I'm going to do is just set that up now. We need to be at 3,000. Speed. I believe it's 1500 feet per minute is a descent rate. About to bring us down. As you can see, our fuel is much better. And what we've got to 4 minutes. Hockham, we need to be at 3,000. Step key is the approach fix. 1900. We'll aim for that. Better idea. Time is going to take. So step key, we have 6 minutes. 6 minutes. So we need to descend. The power back a little bit. Say we're doing 2,000. 10 minutes. 2.5. That's about right. 2.5. Okay, so we're in Iraq. The terrain has changed quite a lot here. There's not a lot of development anywhere in Iraq. You have these small like settlements. Doesn't look like the map is very well modelled. Look at the shape of that lake. There's no way you'd get a lake. I do believe we are pretty close, as well. That there... I do believe that is actually that kind of... Actually, like that. I'm not sure what this... We need to slow down because we're fine. Zero. 21,000. We have 7 minutes. 8 minutes to the end. Can't even bring it up a little bit more, just so we can get to 1900 before the waypoint. Albazra traffic passing ILMAP at flight level 190. And we're going for a straight in approach for runway 14. Papa Hotel, Delta Tango, Foxtrot, Albazra. So if we do a quick turnaround at Basra, and I'm going to do it as a separate flight, the third leg, just so it's separate and more titles work. Yeah, if we do a quick turnaround, I'm going to fire that straight after this flight. We can potentially get to Bahrain within all that traffic that's arriving from India, so we'll see what happens. No, on this flight, it might be worth bringing up the checklist.
Altimeter, set QNH. Set. Fasten seat belts. On.
Fasten seat belts.
Set. Altimeter. Check QNH.
That's fine.
Checked. Transfer intercom 1 and 2. Vertical. Set. Anti-skid. On. Set. Landing lights. On.
And we're going to be passing 2000 soon, so let's
set.
Landing lights on.
ATC request clearance. Request.
Albazra traffic passing flight level 100 inbound SEPKI on approach for runway 14 straight in approach. Filed approach. Papa Hotel Delta Tango Foxtrot. The runway just yet.
Checked.
There's no one there.
Landing gear, 220 kias.
And as we imagined, Devia looks badly modelled. And there are some roads and stuff. Maybe it's not that bad, but I can't imagine the houses that they do in real life. Still don't see a runway. Very clear over here though, not a single cloud in the sky. Or if that's because there's no weather data or something. Okay, yeah, it's filled. Bring that up a little bit because we're down close. Don't want to go underneath. Take that opportunity to get a $4,200. That should also start bleeding off our airspeed. 220 knots landing gear. Got the field in sight there. To be on the correct height for Hockham, which is the initial approach fix. There we go, there's two landing gear. Approach speed, we are aiming for 130 knots.
Down.
Down.
Taxi lights on. Set. On. Motor start 123. Air start. Set. Yaw damper off. Set. Parking brakes, check release. Checked. Air brake set to 1. Set. Air brake set to 2. Set. Thrust reverser on. Guard up.
Yeah, so after landing there, and now try and speed down. Once we get to Zagib, we can do the visual approach. I'm gonna go full flaps here just to get rid of the last bits. Just gonna check the map. Al-Basra traffic, short final, runway 14, landing runway 14. Papa Hotel, Delta Tango Foxtrot, Al-Basra traffic. There we go, we've passed fix. Visual approach. Gonna get rid of the autopilot and fire in manually. We need to bleed off some of the speed so we can pull back on the yoke while it's reducing power. We're gonna be at about 130. A little bit of a crosswind coming from right to left. Kind of having to crab it in here.
1,000.
Just gonna try and trim this out a little bit.
500. 400. 300.
Minimums.
200.
Felt like a reasonable landing. Get the frost reversers on. And some, be okay here, so we're going to vacate the runway here. And there should be somewhere for us to pop, leave. Up here, have a little look at this airport. See where we can park up. It looks like freight and main terminal is there. Probably have to over here. Some kind of executive parking, I guess. Taxi there. Abazra traffic vacated runway to the left. Bravo. Taxi into executive parking via Bravo Tango Hotel. Papa Hotel, Delta Tango Foxtrot. Cool, cool. So we're just going to taxi to the executive parking. In that thing in front of us kind of looks like. Yeah, we probably could have parked there, but I see that. The terrain on this airport, look at this. Might just down a bit. Planes bouncing about everywhere. Yeah, so I'd rather park down here just so we have a few buildings, you know, to take a picture or something. Need to. That's definitely cargo there, the warehouses. That has some hangars and an FBO. That could be like executive parking to me. Maybe that's it down there. That's kind of like a executive building, I don't know. It appears we still have the speed brake out. Yeah, there's not a lot here to be honest. Very flat. And maybe there's some, like some trees and stuff. Where we need to go. There's no taxiways, so taxi lines. And I'm just gonna pull up outside that little building there. That'll do for a picture. And I'll land him at 270, so not the greatest, a little bit heavy, but this plane is said to be feel a little bit heavier than it is. Hopefully in the next flight we can button that. Okay. Shut down the engine. Go. Turn everything off. Gonna drop those pictures. Saved. Something a bit like that. Ooh. Lovely. So thanks for watching this flight, and we will be back shortly to do the final leg into Bahrain from Al Basra here. And yeah, it should be a shorter one this time. So yeah. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you on the next leg, guys. Ciao, ciao.